precious opal holds worlds of fiery color that seem to move within. While each piece is as unique as a fingerprint, many striking patterns have become famous and highly sought after. From puzzle pieces to dancing fish, stardust, to even the Chinese alphabet, today we'll learn how to identify the most beautiful opal patterns. Plus, we'll see how Mother Nature created these unique works of art. Let's start off big with one of the rarest and most prized patterns of all, Harlequin. The name comes from a comedic character of 16th century Italian comedies who wore an outfit of contrasting geometric shapes. In opal, harlequin denotes a regular pattern of stretched square or diamond shapes in a variety of colors. If Willy Wonka ever got into the board game biz, I'm guessing he'd come up with something like this. Though some opals may display partial or mixtures of different patterns, a true harlequin pattern opal is expected to have an almost uniform design across its entire surface. The flagstone pattern is a variation of this, with irregular blocks resembling flagstone pavers. And the jigsaw pattern is yet another version with sharper edges between the shapes. Speaking of sharp, check out our next opal pattern, Pinfire. Here, countless pinpoints of scintillating color flash and flicker as the stone is moved. This is often visible from all directions and makes me think of a sky filled with multicolored stars. Other opal patterns with a celestial bent are the galaxy and stardust patterns, which appear as swirls of color, recalling constellations or distant nebula. One of my favorites along these lines is the Asteria pattern. From the Greek for star-like, the Asteria features particles of color radiating distinctly from the center for an effect resembling an explosion or a kind of starburst. From the interstellar to the microscopic, now might be a good time to talk about how these effects are created. And don't worry, we've still got a lot more patterns coming up. Although opal shares its basic chemical formula with quartz, it also contains a variable amount of loosely bound particles of water. So instead of a crystal lattice of highly ordered atoms, opal's particles form microscopic spheres. Most of the time, these spheres are a jumble of various sizes and form common opal with no play of color. But occasionally, the spheres come out perfectly aligned in neat rows of the same size. And that's where the magic happens. White light is a combination of the wavelengths of all different colors. When light enters these opals, the waves bend around the spheres and spread out again as they travel through the narrow voids between. This spreading out is called diffraction. Throughout this process of bending and weaving, the individual wavelengths begin to overlap and interfere with each other. Certain wavelengths are canceled out and others are boosted, so you see a succession of separated colors. Similar effects happen in the grooves of a butterfly's wings or with tiny pits on the surface of a DVD. The smaller the spheres, the smaller the voids between them, so shorter wavelengths of light are diffracted, those in the blue or violet end of the spectrum. Larger spheres allow more color wavelength diffractions to occur, up to spheres with a diameter of around 350 nanometers, which allow even intense reds, which have the longest wavelengths in the visible light spectrum. Where the spacing between the spheres is very close to the wavelength of light hitting the opal, you have something called Bragg diffraction. Here, it is possible at specific angles for the light to bounce off successive layers and line up perfectly as it returns, creating what is known as positive interference, resulting in intense peaks of reflected energy with light and color appearing much brighter than what entered the material. Super cool! But how do the distinct patterns occur? Well, even though identical size and spacing of the spheres is required for play of color, it is rarely constant throughout the entire stone. Instead, there are breaks in the size of the spheres or the orientation of lines across the opal, which accounts for different patterns. One of the simplest patterns is called broad flash. Here, big, brilliant color flashes across almost the entire face of the stone as it is rocked back and forth. At certain angles, the color may disappear entirely. In contrast, the sheen pattern does not disappear at all, but shifts back and forth between two colors, often blue and green. There are more distinct lines visible in the ribbon pattern opals, which are marked by parallel or adjacent stripes of color. But be sure to look closely. Opal simulants, known as Gilson opals, grown from a silica gel, often display this pattern. In that case, their pattern may look a little too perfect. A natural ribbon pattern should have some incongruities. Finer lines are found in the chaff pattern, which appears as a pile of hay or long, colorful scratches. Chaff patterns are often found mixed in with other opal patterns. The Chinese letter pattern has a bold look all of its own and is one of the most valuable. Here, thick lines of color intersect in a manner that recalls Chinese calligraphy. We should note that these patterns are mostly found in black opals, which is the rarest type of opal. Chiefly found in the small Australian town of Lightning Ridge, the dark body color of black opal is thought to be caused by trace elements of carbon and iron oxide. The play of color often appears brilliantly set against this background. But our next pattern is usually found in Ethiopian opals. The honeycomb pattern consists of rough hexagons of color outlined by veins of common opal. Not surprisingly, nature references are a common device in opal pattern naming. There's the fern pattern, which looks like long, sharp leaves branching out from a stem. Moss pattern has a bushy texture of color across much of the surface. The clover pattern features bulbous patches of color bunched together, while feather has long, soft streaks that fan out like strokes from a thick brush. The floral pattern is a flowing group of multicolor patches that resembles an impressionist painting. Sounds like you could have an entire garden of opal. Or how about a zoo? Peacock patterns feature tight bursts of color that unfurl from the edge of the stone, sprouting out like a peacock's tail. In mackerel pattern, thin ribbons of color seem to twist as they move across the stone like little swimming fish. And finally, there's cat's eye, where a flash of color appears as a thin line rolling across the opal, like a more vibrant version of the chatoyant effect found in some more conventional gems. As you can see, identifying opal patterns requires an eye for detail and an active imagination. And that's what makes it fun. We're out of time for today, but would you like to know more? Let us know down in the comments. And while you're there, don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring that bell so you don't miss our future episodes. Thanks for watching.